Me and the Fire Lord are exactly the same. Just ask my kids.
Hey, we're the cast of Avatar The Last Airbender.
This is Casting Notes.
What's the most exciting thing about your role?
I grew up watching the show. I was like 7 years old watching Avatar The Last Airbender. It was like that made me like want to even try doing martial arts.
Oh.
So I started doing martial arts when I was 8 years old. It's like Sokka wants to be a warrior so bad. I relate to that a lot, wanting to be a warrior so bad.
Yeah.
So it's cool to like, on a personal level, maybe inspire some other kid to, you know, be a warrior and
right.
get to do martial arts Aww. And stuff like that. Aww. So it's
yeah,
cool.
That's really sweet. I think the most exciting part was like how different she is from who I am. You could spill soup in my lap, but I'd probably apologize to you. But I think that it was really like actually cathartic to like be like in like this armor and like have to sit a certain way and like look up people up and down, you know?
Yeah. To be part of like this iconic sort of franchise.
Yeah.
And especially too, like, you know, you look up at the casting wall and it's all Asian faces. And I have to admit, that brought a tear to my eye.
It's exciting that we get to work alongside each other, especially versus having to compete against each other. Now,
totally.
I feel like. Mm-hmm.
I mean, I couldn't say that I was a fan before I figured out I booked it. But after I booked it, since then, I've watched the show about 26 times. Being able to see myself in this is going to be really cool. And I'm really excited.
If the world is gonna have any chance, it's gonna need Aang.
I grew up on the show as well, so it's like I see so much of myself in Katara, and I grew up seeing myself in Katara, especially being such a strong role model for young women. And it's just so important to me, and I'm so grateful that I have the opportunity to be that for other young girls.
Yeah, for me, me and the Fire Lord are exactly the same. Just ask my kids. It's actually one of the best things about being an actor is that you get licensed to play characters that you are not in real life, you know?
Yeah.
And for me as a dad, it was really interesting to see the way I chose to parent my kids versus the way Ozai parented his kids. And I look at Ozai through that lens, like, so what was the trauma he imparted on Zuko? And it's pretty obvious in season one, but what was the trauma imparted on him? And that's the kind of exploration of the character that I was interested in.
Did you guys have any on-set rituals to get into character?
When it was us filming together, us just goofing around backstage and like playing with each other and just like having fun, you know? I feel like that got me into just the comfortability between our group.
Okay, so guys, what are some creative decisions that you made for your character and why?
Luckily, our writers gave Zuko a character arc in the first season alone versus over the three seasons in the animated series. And so I really got to play around with Zuko's emotions and the sadness that lied within him, and versus just being angry all the way out through every scene.
Mm-hmm.
And you actually get to see some really heartfelt moments between him and Uncle Iroh.
We made the conscious decision to not make Iroh sound like the way Mako spoke in the animated series.
Yeah.
I didn't want to be a mimic.
Yeah.
You know, I wanted to bring the truth, the honesty, the authenticity of who Iroh was and what he was trying to accomplish with Zuko especially. So it was really exciting and terrifying to sort of take that leap.
I feel like a creative decision that I made was like, Sokka is so intensely physical in the animated show in a way that's like unnatural for like a human.
Right.
And I watched like some stuff like trying to figure out like how much was I gonna play into that like physicality of the character as a real person.
Yeah.
So trying to find like comedy in different ways in that aspect and not losing like the funness of the character obviously, but just trying to ground that a little bit was a creative decision that I tried to make and just make sure like every time we had opportunities to find comedy, we could find it.
Yeah.
Right, there goes the savior of the world.
Thanks for watching. Be sure to check out Avatar The Last Airbender only on Netflix.